Thank you so much. So, good morning, everybody here. So today we just look into one of the use cases where you can use machine learning in cybersecurity. That's intelligent intrusion detection system. So this was one of my research product. I've been working on this from the past 2 years nearly, and I've published in a couple of conferences as well as a poster from Intel, and there was a grant approved by Intel as well. So just let's get started. So a quick background, if you see why exactly intrusion detection system, what is the motivation, why I have chosen this. So in today's world, if you see, there are a lot of importance for the network and system security, and you have been hearing a lot of attacks that are happening day-to-day life, and really new attacks are burning, new attacks are coming up. By the time I speak this statement, there are probably one more new malware or virus has been generated or created, and a lot of attacks have been done. And especially information privacy has also become one of the paramount importance, and it has to be taken care of properly by any industry or the business that are leading with. So these are the major things, or this is the main motivation for me to work on this particular problem. So to cut down and to describe the whole problem in a nutshell, if you put it, our intruders have become smart, and nowadays they are easily able to break the systems and attack the systems and create any kinds of attacks, such as denial of service or inject some malware. And if recently seen ransomware attacks, how much hype they have caused it, and so a lot of other such attacks are happening. So as a traditional approach, I just thinking like can I build a system which can solve these kind of attacks intelligently, and how exactly to tackle this kind of situation. So just started searching about what kind of intrusion detection systems are there in the market. And if you see, there are a lot of ideas, such as Snort or anything which are popular right now. So they use traditional techniques, they are mostly rule-based systems. So they define some rules, they preset some rules, and then they try to predict what exactly, or they try to identify what exactly the attack is. So my approach was pretty much in a different way. So I was as a human, what are the things that we are able to do, or a network administrator is approaching, and how the network systems administrators approach on a particular while he or she is inspecting the log files and all. So I plan to design a system, a completely hybridized version of hybridized intrusion detection system, by using some of the machine learning or deep learning techniques, such that we can introduce the human intelligence to the system and automate the identification of intrusions, rather than having a huge number of administrators and network administrators and trying to inspect the entire log file throughout the days and days. And if we are able to automate the process and we give a whole log of like a bunch of summary over the things that have happened in the past, so it becomes much easier for the network administrator to understand what exactly is there. So let me give you a much more feel on what exactly the idea is and how exactly things work. So this is just a normal network security software. Apart from firewall, usually all the businesses maintain the IDS as well as one more layer for security. And it just all it does is it tries to identify the malicious activities that are happening in the network, especially outside the malicious. It tries to able to detect the malicious user who are coming out from outside the organization. So there are majorly two types of IDS. One is active IDS and one is passive IDS. So active IDS is the system, as the word says, it's pretty active. The moment it identifies any intrusion, so as I said, just to define the term again, intrusion. So intrusion is nothing but something, a suspicious activity done by a person who is not not an who doesn't have an authorization to do that. So we'll look into some of the use cases as well, and you'll understand what could be these kind of the problems and all. So when such case is identified or when such case is hitted, so active IDs is usually tend to go ahead and try to block the administrator. It completely try to block the user, and it completely tries to eliminate the access to him. So there are a hell lot of problems out with there. So just in case network administrator or the person who is authorized to do and who is authenticated to do it, and admin or a user or the employee tries to perform some activities on the system which goes beyond the rules by 1% or 2%, still since it's a rule based system, so more or less like if else conditions that were designed in the system. So what it does is it just prevents access for that administrator or employee as well when he just crosses by even a 1%. So that's one of the major issue when it comes to IDS. And then completely on the opposite edge, there is a passive IDS where it does nothing when it identify any intrusion. All it does is informs or alerts the network administrator by could be by SMS, it could be by email, or any other mechanism that we can set up. So on top of it, there are a couple of other stuff that we can look at into it, and one is the signature based. So signature based. When we say, especially in the security, every attack or every behavior we can define with signatures. So every malware or anything can be probably could be defined as a signature. So we as a system administrators will usually collect a huge set of signatures and put it in a database. And when they observe any kind of activity, they try to match it with a signature in the collected database. So if it matches, they identify it as an attack. So the problem here again is the database has to be quite up to date all the day. And whenever there's a new attack, it has to be updated immediately. So that's one of the major issue. Ultimately, you can clearly understand that it won't be able to identify the new attacks and all. It just sees the past attacks and tries to predict something. Whereas anomaly based is something which does these things. So it takes out the baseline patterns. So if you have a database of signatures of all the attacks, so it tries to take out the patterns that are there, and then based on that, so if a new attack comes in and if it is matching with the pattern that are there with the signatures that are there in the database, maybe it can predict as an attack. So that's one of the other approach. And again, there are a couple of other approaches, like it could be network based or host based. So host based is something that we install the software at a host level in each and every system of an of employers, whereas network based is something we deploy at a central switch or the central routers. So to put everything is good for visualization in a tree form. So intrusion detection system, it could be from if you see a kind of technique. So one is intrusion technique and the source of data. So the data these can be again classified into host detection, network based detection, whereas here we can see anomaly detection as well as signature detection. And as we move, so there are three types of approaches that can be followed. So if you see here, a couple of approaches here are programmed. So when we say programmed, as I said, all the rule-based systems. So you define the set of rules, if conditions, and then say what could be a malicious activity, what could be a non-malicious activity. Whereas self-learning, you use time series or machine learning. Whereas here, you don't define completely a set of rules. Of course, you make the machine learn and then try to identify. Try to give the freedom to machine to identify which could be a malicious and non-malicious activity, and there are a hell lot of algorithms that can be used here or there. So this is just quick research in like ML for cybersecurity. So if you see a lot of right now there are a really, really huge number of applications where machine learning is needed, especially all kinds of building tools. You when you build a penetration testing framework, you can automate it using machine learning. And there are especially if I talk about intrusion detection in network security. So intrusion detection system is one of the major part or major place where you can use machine learning, because as the problem was clearly defined in the beginning, if you can inject the human intelligence to the machine, it would automate the process that we the painful process that we are doing. So this is one of the research papers that was published. So machine learning for signature detection or malware detection, we can see. So there was a technique that I've used. They called fuzzy techniques. So fuzzy technique is nothing but how many of you here know probabilities? Yeah, most of you, right? So does anyone of you know of what a fuzzy is? Okay, cool. So there are a few people who knows fuzzy as well. So when you say probability, like let's say probability of for raining tomorrow is 60% or 0.6. So you mean, so there are chances, like if you take 7 days, out of that 60% of the days in the past 1 week would probably be raining. Or generally, if I just take when you say 60%, so out of 100 days, it rains 60 days. So that's what we generally mean by probability. But whereas fuzzy is completely different. So fuzzy also has a similar values like 0.6. So when you say, so it is the statement is true with a probability of 0.6, and the statement is false, the probability of 0.4. So a fuzzy is a logic, or the fuzzy is a pattern that gives that allows a particular statement to stay in both the classes. So especially why fuzzy is like let's say a situation can be malicious to some extent and non-malicious to other extent. So we can give the fuzzy rule, fuzzy logic, saying that it's like 0.6 it's malicious and 0.4 it's non-malicious. So it allows that particular signature to be in both the states. I can set my rules like if fuzzy value, the value that we get is like 0.8 in malicious, I can simply prevent it from the system. If it is 0.2 or 3, I can happily allow that. That's how the logic works. And this is in general why exactly we need to move anomaly based ideas, because signature detection, signature based ideas are not able to get anything or not able to identify because of new attacks that are coming up in our day-to-day life. So these are the major attacks that types of attacks that we are right now attempting, or we are probably solving it. So one is DOS. So DOS is attacker. Most of you might be knowing what exactly the DOS, denial of service. So in a fraction of a second, a particular user tries to get the whole system down by sending multiple packets or multiple requests to the particular system. Whereas probe attack is one of the things in information security, tries to gain the access to the whole user database or whatever the information about the target host can take. And user to root, so let's say a person has a user access, whereas if he's trying to use the system root commands, trying to access the root files and stuff like that. So that's one of the important issue to tackle. And then R2L is nothing but the other part of it. So a person doesn't have a authorized, he or she is not an authorized user, but still try to attack this, try to gain the access to the system. So some of the experimentations, as usual, if you see any of the machine learning problem, the basic stuff, the basic approach would be dealing with the data. So the same case here. So initially, I just developed a small detection system which was trained on the data set that were taken, like such as KDD, CUP data set and all. But whereas as I move forward, so I've divided into different layers. So these are the layers that I've working currently with. So at net layer, and then application layer, and then transport layer. So the system will be able to identify the attack at the respective layer. So simple technique that was chosen, a simple LSTM, it's nothing but gated recurrent units, was taken with just one single hidden unit and one single hidden layer. So why LSTMs is one of the question that comes in everybody's mind when we see. So LSTMs are as I said, the attacks are more or less on a time series. So if you say I can't simply say this particular attack happened by just inspecting the one particular packet that's there right there. So I would probably say it is an attack when I able to identify the behavior that's happened in the past series of packets that are coming from one particular source. So in a certain time frame. So I need a algorithm, or I need a technique that can take all these things into consideration and then process the information and then gives me results of stuff. So this is one of the simple techniques that I've chosen to do that. So and for field selection, I have chosen decision trees and random forests, especially to extract the important features. So if you actually would inspect the whole packet and take out the information from the whole packet, it would come around 225 features or so. So 225 features is really huge set, and if I have to say at a production in a production environment, and if I have to inspect all those 25 features and then apply machine learning, it takes maybe seconds as well, which is not really needed for me. So my system has to be so fast and so accurate such that if an intrusion is coming in, I have to detect it at a, such a speed rates and then try to block him immediately so that I won't give access to him or lose the information or the importance out of it. That's clearly understand. So the feature set that are pretty much important has to be considered, and there's a huge requirement for feature selection. So that's where we use simple decision trees and random forests in the initial level, and then identify the best features. So again, as I said, we identify the attacks based on the layer wise. So rather than just approaching at one layer, so series of layers where the malware detection happens. So first at application layer, these are the features that helps in finding out the attacks. So whereas in network layer, these are the features that find maybe majorly help so in finding attacks. So some of the results, if I have to speak, so on training data set that we collected, whatever the accuracies are, we got out nearly like around 98%, 99% and all. But we have tested with, So we have tested with 19 businesses in India. So it's a product under a startup called iCybersol. It's one of the major product. And we have tested it with 19 businesses and for about 100 days. And we have got around 88 to 90% accuracies. And one thing that we majorly identified is the penetration testers over there have continuously tried to gain access and try to do some new attacks which are not there in the database that we created. For every 100 attacks, they try to create nearly 70 to 80 were new almost, and most of them the system was able to identify, and that's where we can see how well the system is working. And so best thing about is all the training and everything was not just happened in the cloud. Everything was the production, we deployed the whole system on a Raspberry Pi with a Intel Movidius NCS stick. So that's one of the fantastic thing I can say, like the entire computation happens on a just with a Raspberry Pi board. Like even the hardware, if you see, it's just a small stuff. Like most of you know what Raspberry Pi boards are. Yep. You can take any small microcontroller and then I can put a the stick and then deploy it. So open research issues right now. One thing, as I said, like it has to be much more faster, and when it comes to be I have to say, it should be able to detect within a fraction of second. And then another situation I can say is data sets. So still the data sets are not upgraded to the current day attacks, and we need really use data set to improve the efficiencies and accuracies. So that's one more one more issue that we have right now. Yep, this can be maybe it can be furthermore improvised. See, like I'd say, if it's a 89% accuracy, still there is 11% or you know, lot of cases it's still missing it. So I can't even compromise on one such failure, because the whole organization security is going to be depend on this. So accuracy has to be really so high, around like 96 and 97, so that we can, since it's a very critical systems and has to work. So that's what about the system. So I like I'll be available here. You can talk about like more details about the system. So just 25 minutes. I just gave a quick introduction how the whole system was developed. And yeah, if you have any questions, you can always feel free to reach out to me on these links. And just a quick introduction about myself. I'm a founder of iCybersol and a non-profit organization called Society. So iCybersol is basically into the cybersecurity domain, and the Society is in AI domain. So Society is a not-for-profit motive, and we train students, developers, and faculties, and all the people in machine learning and deep learning. The past 6 months, happily, I'm proud to say that we have trained nearly 10,000 students and 1,200 faculties through different programs. Since I said like not for profit, and anybody who are willing to have such trainings, we are happy to do it online as well. You can just always reach out to me. And if it is in from India, we are the whole team can fly to the place and then teach your students. And yeah, that's what we into. Okay, then. Thank you so much. And I'll be available here. You can, any questions you can post. Right now, the community edition will be under OWASP organization. So recently, OWASP organization has approved my project. So we are launching the community, we are open sourcing the community edition to it. No. The whole source, I mean, the basic feature, with the basic features and all, we are open sourcing it under OWASP organization, so it will be soon published. Yeah. Pardon? Yeah, for the entire artificial intelligence or machine learning part, that is there, Python. Yes. Yes, the whole packet inspector that we have written, so that uses some of the bash